Hello, welcome back to Unit 7.3. In this unit, we want to create the simplified net of HCAST 1.
We are doing this to determine the principal connectivity of the network, the connectivity of the underlying net. This means how the SPUs and not the individual atoms are connected to each other. Therefore, we want to condense the inorganic SPU from a cluster to a simple node. And we want to do the same with the organic SPU.
Topos has a routine to reduce the secondary building units to simple vertices at the respective centers of gravity. However, it needs our assistance to determine the actual building units. Right now, everything is interconnected, and you will need to make cuts between the SPUs. What do we mean by that? Look at this combination of SPUs. Where do we place the cuts? Well, we put the cuts where the different types of SPU are connected with each other. In the case of HCAST 1, this connection is the bond from the aromatic ring to the carboxylic carbon. Let's look at this bond in Topos. In order to place a cut at this bond, we need to know the labels of the atoms involved in this bond. Click on this button to show labels for each atom. The atom that belongs to the inorganic SPU is labeled C2. The atom that belongs to the organic SPU is labeled C1. Therefore, the cut must be placed between C1 and C2. Close the window with the crystal structure. Open the adjacency matrix of HCAST 1. Right-click on the entry of HCAST 1 and choose Edit. Go to the Adjacency Matrix tab. Unfold the entry of the atom labeled C1. Now we want to modify this connection to the atom C2. Right-click on this bond. Change the bond type to hydrogen bond. Of course, this is not correct in a chemical sense, but by marking this bond as a hydrogen bond, we tell Topos that this is a special bond, namely a connection between the inorganic and the organic SPU. Click Save to close the adjacency matrix. Click then on the pencil again to view the modified structure of HCAST 1.
Because the bond between C1 and C2 has been set as a hydrogen bond, it is no longer displayed in this representation of the crystal structure.
And it is always good to inspect the structure if really all connections between the inorganic and the organic SPU are marked as hydrogen bonds. In HCAST 1, all bonds between the inorganic and the organic SPU are symmetry related to each other. This means we only need to modify one bond for the whole structure. Okay, close this window. Now we will actually simplify this structure to its underlying net. Click on this button to run the ADS program. ADS stands for Auto Determination Sequence. Another window opens. In this window, click Options. This window has multiple tabs. In the Common tab, it is important that this option is enabled, Save Simplified Net. Otherwise, the creation of the underlying net won't take place. Sometimes a warning shows up. It tells you, when you simplify a structure to the underlying net, the classification is turned off. That's all right. Just click OK. In the Topology tab, we need to set hydrogen bonds as the special bonds. This means that they are treated by Topos as connections between discrete molecules. In the field for H bonds, simply set this in the middle position as MOL. The other three tabs, Tiling, Molecular VDP, and Continuous, remain unchanged. Click OK to close the options window. Now click Run.
Topaz will ask you to create another database for the simplified net with the name hcast1_c. Click Yes and enter 1 as your user code.
Another window shows up. Here you have to click Whole Molecule. Topaz now calculates the simplified net. Once the process is complete, simply close this window. Now, a second window will pop up on the home screen of Topaz. This is the simplified net of HCAST1. To keep things clear, rename this entry. Right-click on the entry and choose Edit. In this field, choose another name to indicate that this is the simplified net of HCAST1. Click OK to save. Click on the pencil to take a look at it. You can see this is a binodal net. The four connecting nodes are represented by titanium atoms. The three connecting nodes are represented as scandium atoms. Don't be confused by these dummy atoms. This is just how Topaz works with these systems. Okay, good job so far. Together we have analyzed the crystal structure, modified the adjacency matrix, and created the underlying net of HCAST1.
In the next unit, we will finally classify this net, meaning that we will obtain the coordination sequence and the vertex symbol for this net.